Namaste there, and welcome to the Healthy Ho YouTube channel. I'm Monica Ho Ellers, and this is a 15-minute, very stretchy, very calm and peaceful yoga cool-down. Great for after an intense workout. Okay, so let's begin on our mat. We're going to start at the top here. So you're going to take a nice deep breath in. Exhale. And again, you want to push the hips forward when you do this for a slight back bend. Look up at the ceiling. Exhale. Now we're going to push the hips back into down, forward fold. Grab the backs of your legs here if that's available to you. Okay. Hang out here. Let the head be nice and low. The neck, I should say. Let the head be heavy and shake your head. No. We are not putting up with this quarantine. And yes. Yes, I can find peace during this time. Okay, and then take a deep breath in and come all the way back up. Getting some oxygen to those cells down in front of you. Okay, so again, take one last deep breath in, not one last. Exhale, forward fold. But again, you can bend the knees as generously as you'd like. You can straighten them a little, wherever you feel that stretches today, okay? I want you to be really aware of where you might be holding your tension today. If you're just coming out of turbo kick, it might be everywhere, right? So just be mindful of that. All right, go ahead and put your hands at the outside of each foot. Take the right leg back, okay? And then the left back to meet it. Oh my goodness, slippy slidey. All right. You can press the heels down if you want. You can dance into downward or in downward dog. You can walk. All right, I'm gonna have to get a towel here in a second because I am slip sliding. All right, go ahead and sit back into child's pose. I'm gonna go grab a towel, so sit back and press the elbows into the mat. Hang out there, you're gonna inhale, expand the rib cage between the knees, and exhale. You wanna take these breaths as slowly as you can. Okay, a four count is ideal, but if not, no worries. Okay, just relax, forehead to the mat, inhale, and exhale. Okay, we're gonna come back into downward dog again. So walk your hands forward, spread the fingers, spread the toes on the balls of the feet, and you can dance into downward dog if you'd like. You're really getting the back of the body here. Okay, from the shoulders all the way down to the calves. Okay. All right, so from here, let's go ahead and set up. You're gonna bring your left foot towards the middle of the mat a little bit more. Lift your right heel. Okay, three-legged dog. Cool if you want to hang out here. Bend that right knee if you want. Look under the right armpit. If you want to flip, bring your left hand towards the middle of the mat and then push the hips up to the sky in a nice bridge. Okay, opening the front of the body. If not, you're in three-legged dog, downward dog, or child's pose. Whatever works for you. But let's take two breaths wherever you are. Exhale. I would say inhale through your nose, but I can't do that right now, so inhale. Exhale. If your nostrils are available to you, by all means, use them. Okay, flippers, if you flipped, come on back over. If you're in three-legged dog, awesome. Let's bring that right knee behind or in between the hands, okay? So two ways to do this. Right here is great. Right here is great. Whatever works for you. Go ahead and put the top of the left foot, which is your back foot, on the mat, okay? And you're either gonna come over to your left or you're gonna do a forward fold over your right knee, okay? So before we do that though, let's do a slight back bend, rolling the shoulders down, and then come on down to wherever you are. You can stack your fists to make a pillow. And I want you to think about sinking, becoming one with the mat on the exhales. Now I'm gonna count these out for you. Okay, so you're going to inhale and expand the rib cage. Exhale, let everything fall and get heavy. Okay, inhale, expand. Exhale, get heavy. So if you feel your shoulders kind of dropping, awesome. Inhale. Relax your face, your jaw. Sorry, that was supposed to be exhale. Inhale, expand. Exhale, maybe the hip opens up.
Inhale, float. Exhale, sink.
Think to yourself, am I crinkling my eyes? Is my jaw tense? Inhale. See if you can really release it on the exhale.
Let's try one more here. Inhale. Exhale.
Okay, so we're going to gently find the space underneath our armpits. Peel up off the mat, look up slowly. Now, you have two options. You can go into all four, which is cool, right here.
Right here, baby.
Remember, Dave, we're not jamming those wrists into the mat. We're going to float. You do that by pointing the tailbone down. You can lift your knee right here. If you want a little bit more, you can go into three-legged dog and do the same thing. But we're going to get some blood back into that joint on the right side, okay? Rotate it,
rotate it,
and then the other way. Two, three, four. Okay, so if you are all four right here, you're gonna come up into downward dog. All right, take your time. As I had to tell my mom, yoga is not a race, it is not about the destination, it is about the journey. Okay, so we're gonna actually do lizard on this side. So you can go about it by either going into three-legged dog, okay, and then putting the right foot on the outside of the right hand, which means sometimes it's off your mat, like for me. Okay, if that's too much, come down into all four and then just put the foot on the outside. So whichever way you decide to come, like I said, this way to here, or this way to here. Just get there, take your time, we waiting. All right, so let's go over some of the mechanics here. So your foot might wobble out. It may not be on the mat. Mine's not on the mat, okay? Go ahead and put your left knee down, and then you can rest the top of the foot on the mat. Now, if at any time it cramps, flex it, all right? This is totally cool right here, but what you don't want to be doing is like relaxing. I'm like, oh my God, I'm just going to lean to the left side of my body. This is a pretty active pose, I would say. So, okay, so I'm up. My shoulders are away from my ears. You can gently come down and see if this works, okay? Now don't worry if your foot drifts out. Like my foot, you're gonna see is gonna drift out. If this is comfortable for you, come on down to the forearms. Maybe you're on one like this. Maybe you're on two. Maybe you're not at all. But what you're trying to do is open up that right hip. So pull that right hip crease back a little, okay? And let's just breathe into it. Now if at any time this is too much, come on out of it. Okay, you can come out a bit like this. That's totally fine too. All right, two breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, so from here, let's gently climb back up if you were on your elbows. Wiggle your foot, heel toe in towards the center of your mat, okay? We're now gonna flex that front foot. Keep that front knee very bent if you want, okay? Well, where you should feel this is in gluteville. Gluteville. Shoulders down, you're gonna rock back and forth, okay? Okay, if one direction feels great and you wanna keep it there, cool, okay? Remember, this is your practice. I'm just your guide. All right, my friends. All right, so we're just gonna put our right hand on the inside of our foot, heel toe it out, and then come to all four, okay? So we're gonna walk it forward. We are gonna go back into downward dog. If you don't want to, you've like had enough, go ahead and sit back in a child's pose or stay in all four, whatever works. But you're gonna slowly get to downward dog if you'd like, okay? Again, you can walk it up there. Walk the dog. Okay, because now we're going to go into pigeon. So you're going to move that right. No, my friends. We have to flip on the other side. Oh my gosh, we have to flip on the other side. All right. So go ahead and bring your left heel up. It's a three-legged dog. You're going to bend that knee if you want to and look under your left armpit. Now, if you don't want to, cool. This is cool. This is cool. So is child's pose. If you're in three-legged dog, you bend that knee and you want to flip, go ahead, flip towards your camera. Take it very slowly and easily. wherever you are, though, we are going to take two breaths. And again, I apologize. I am breathing through my mouth, but ideally you breathe through your nose, okay? So inhale. Exhale. And one more. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, flippers, go ahead and take your time flipping over. Three-legged dog, people. You can keep that leg in the air, okay? So we are going to bend the knee and bring it behind or in the middle of our hands, whatever is most comfortable for you, okay? So as you can see, I move my hips over so that they're square towards the mat. All right, of course, if that doesn't feel right, don't do it. Back away from movement. Put the top of the foot on the back foot on the mat. Roll the shoulders down to slight back bend, look up, and then either forward fold in front of you or to the right, whatever works. You can stack your fists again here. Okay, but I'm gonna count our breaths out. Try to follow as much as you can, and if you're doing your own breathing pattern, good for you, yogi. All right, inhale. Exhale, release. Again, inhale, on that inhalation, inhalation, scan your body for any tense areas, and then exhale and release them if you can. Inhale. Exhale, let go. Inhale. Exhale, release. Inhale, scan your body. Exhale, shoot it away. And one more, inhale. Exhale. Okay, again. You're going to gently and slowly find the space underneath your armpits, okay? I'm going to slowly peel up and look up. How are we doing? Hopefully we're well. Again, it's all about the process, so don't rush through this stuff. So go ahead and get into all four if you want. Flex your right foot if you want to. Get into three-legged dog. Wherever you are, you are going to rotate that left knee. Get some blood back into that joint. Take your time. And then switch to... Okay, so if you're on all four, go ahead and dance into downward dog. Take your time getting there. If you're in downward dog, we're going to hang out here unless you're tired. Hang out in child's pose. Okay? All right. So, a couple ways to do this. From all four, I'll show you. You're just going to bring your left foot on the outside of your left hand. If you're in downward dog, you take a three-legged dog and bring it to the outside. Okay? Easy peasy. Right here. Back of the top. Top of the back foot goes on the mat. Again, if it cramps, flex it. Alright? And again, look at my foot is not on this mat. Alright, if you want to, you feel right, come on down to your elbows. Shoulders away from the ears, so stretch them back. Left foot comes out. Mine's like almost on its side. Side, okay? But wherever you are, hopefully through your nose, you take two deep breaths. Here we go. Expand the rib cage. And exhale. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. And again, one more breath. Exhale. Okay, you're going to climb up. We are almost out of time, my friends. Okay, wiggle that foot back to the center. Flex that foot. We're going to gently rock it back and forth. Okay? And feel that stretch all the way through the glute and the hamstring. Shoulders away from the ears. Okay. And then we're going to actually bend the knees and then sit down. All right, we are going to do one last movement before Shavasana, and that is Happy Baby. Why? Because I just feel like you can't leave class
any other way than with a smile on your face if you're doing happy baby. Okay, our hips hold a lot of tension. So, yeah, grab the backs of your backs, the outsides of your feet, and roll with it. Just roll with it, baby. Okay, you might not be able to roll side to side. That's cool, but this really leaves you, well, do I really need to say it leaves you in a vulnerable position, but means you're kind of like open to new things, like, oh, I don't know, new ways to maneuver around the pandemic. You know, but we hold a lot of stress and tension and emotion, actually, in our hips. So by opening them up, hopefully we can kind of release them. And honestly, while you're on your back rolling like a baby, it kind of just brings you, okay, well, we don't want the tantrum part of baby, but, you know, like the, oh, yeah, life is kind of simple while I'm lying on my back here. All right. Okay, everybody. So grab your knees, give yourself a big hug, and then we're just going to come out into dead body pose, Shavasana. Okay, let the heels turn in, let the fingertips curl, let the belly rise. We're going to do three breaths here. I'll count them for you. Here we go. Inhale. Exhale, shoulder blades sink into that mat. Inhale, scan the body for any tension. Exhale, let it shoot out through the fingertips, toes, and the head. One more, inhale. And exhale. Okay, slowly bring your knees into your chest. We're going to roll to one side. Hopefully it's where your screen is. Keep your eyes closed if you want to. Come up ever so slowly, and come up into seated cross-legged position. I'm going to open my eyes so I can say hi. I'm going to take one deep breath in. Exhale. We're going to forward fold. I thank you so much for sharing your mini practice with me today. Have a wonderful day, and just remember we're all in this together, and we're going to get through it. We are. Okay, but find something that you're grateful for today, or, I mean, just one thing, okay? Write it down, maybe, and add or comment in the sections. Thanks so much. Have a great day.